Hello friends, today we are going to consider next important basic concepts of magnetism. So two important physical terms, first one magnetic flux and second one magnetic induction. So what is the magnetic flux? It is a scalar physical quantity which gives us idea about how much magnetic field is linked with a given area. You just imagine there is a uniform magnetic field which can be represented with the help of straight parallel equidistant magnetic lines of force. Suppose this is of induction B1. And if we consider a small area inside this magnetic field, say it is a ds. And suppose now it is normally placed, it is perpendicular like this. Say this is induction and this area. Then how much magnetic field is linked with this area? It is explained in terms of this magnetic flux, scalar quantity. Now generally small area inside magnetic field we are considering vector, and that vector is always represented on normal. Normal means a line perpendicular to cross section passing through center. So this will be normal. On this normal, you can represent this area with a straight arrow line. Arrow indicate direction and length of arrow line gives its magnitude. Now for this situation, see here. Magnetic flux is defined as total number of magnetic lines of force passing normally through that area. Whatever may be the area, through that area, how many lines are passing normally, not inclined, okay, not parallel. So how many lines are passing normally, that number itself is called as a magnetic flux. Now magnetic flux, generally it is given by formula, d phi is equal to s dot product of two vectors, induction and area vector. As it is a dot product, it is always a scalar quantity. In magnitude form, you can write d phi is equal to always bds cos theta. Because there is a dot product and hence we have to write cos theta, where theta be the angle between induction vector and area vector. For shown situation here theta is 0, hence we can write here when theta is equal to 0 we will get s cos 0 is 1, therefore d phi is equal to bds. Are you getting it? And therefore we can write b is equal to d phi by ds, which helps us to define second term, that is magnetic induction. Very very important. So once again focus on this first term. Magnetic flux through given area is defined as total number of magnetic lines of force passing normally through it. Passing normally through it. Just remember formula, d phi is equal to b bar dot ds bar. So d phi is equal to bds cos theta. It is a scalar, it is clear to you because it is dot product. What about unit? So SI unit of magnetic flux is nothing but Weber. W-E-B-E-R, name of scientist, capital W, small b. Similarly, it has CGS unit. What about CGS unit? CGS unit of magnetic flux is Maxwell. Maxwell. And conversion factor between these two units, yes, Maxwell is smaller, Weber is larger unit. So 1 Weber is equal to 10 raised to 8 Maxwell. Remember, this is very very important concept. 1 Weber is equal to 10 raised to 8 Maxwell. Now here, every time induction vector and area vector may not be parallel. So diagrammatically just remember, if this is induction B bar and if this is area vector ds bar, if angle between them is theta, then magnetic flux always given by this equation. Now with reference to this equation, d phi is equal to bds cos theta, yes, if theta is 0, cos 0 is 1, we will get yes, d phi is equal to bds, hence we got b is equal to d phi by ds, and this is nothing but indirectly definition for magnetic induction. So what is magnetic induction? It is a vector quantity. Why it is introduced? Just to explain or describe the strength of magnetic field at a given point. You just imagine in this region there is a magnetic field. If we consider any one point, at that point how much is the strength of magnetic field? It is expressed in terms of this vector. How it is defined? Magnetic induction at a given point is defined as magnetic flux per unit area, means around this point if we construct 1 meter square area, how much flux is linked with it? What in by flux? Total number of lines passing normally. We simply imagine around this point if 1 meter square area is constructed, then total number of magnetic lines of force passing normally through that unit area is nothing but magnetic induction. So, or simply you can say that magnetic induction is defined as the ratio of magnetic flux to the given area. So as per this formula, SI unit comes out as a Weber per meter square, very very important. Or another unit used, it is Tesla. TESLA, Tesla, again name of scientist. So capital T, you may write this is equal to Weber per meter square. Both are SI unit. There is one more SI unit, but that is on the basis of basic concept. And that basic concept is compared with intensity. We know that analogous with this induction in magnetism, in electrostatic, there is a basic intensity term. So intensity is also vector and is defined as the force acting on a given charge placed at that point, E bar equal to F bar by Q. Similarly, basic, with this analogy, we can say that induction at a given point is defined as magnetic force acting on a given pole strength at that point. So, by comparing with this intensity definition, induction can also be defined as the magnetic force acting on a unit positive pole strength at that point. So, with this formula, one more unit is possible, force Newton, pole strength ampere meter. So, Newton per ampere meter, this is one more possible unit. So, there are three SI units now here. First one, Tesla. Second one, Weber per meter square. And now, third one is nothing but Newton per ampere meter. Very, very important. It has CGS unit also. What is CGS unit? CGS unit of magnetic induction is Gauss. G-A-U-S-S, Gauss. And the conversion factor between these two units, remember, yes, 1 Tesla is always equal to 10 raised to 4 Gauss. 1 Tesla is equal to 10 raised to 4 Gauss. So these are two important physical terms. First one, magnetic flux, and second one is a magnetic induction. Like that, we will consider here one more physical term and is called as magnetic potential. Next term, magnetic potential. What do you mean by magnetic potential? Yes. It is almost similar to electric potential. Symbol is also same. Only you can use suffix here M just to distinguish electric and magnetic potential. Magnetic potential is also defined in same wording as that of electric potential. Work done to displace unit positive pole strength from infinity to given point. Means if we consider a point inside magnetic field, then in order to displace a small pole strength, say small m, from infinity to that point, in the opposite direction of magnetic induction is called as magnetic potential. So Vm is always equal to W divided by small m. So SI unit will be joule per ampere meter. Very, very important. Now if we consider any pole, suppose this is a N pole of pole strength M. If this is the magnetic field of this N pole, okay, if this magnetic field of this N pole, then at a distance r from its center, if we consider any one point, then at that point induction is given by basic formula. See here, induction is given by, just now I have described that formula, magnetic induction, it is a vector quantity. For N pole, direction is always outward, remember, and for S pole, direction is inward, similar to positive and negative charges for intensity. So induction at that point, it is given by, yes, B is equal to magnetic force divided by pole strength. Now this is the pole strength placed at that point, getting it? So if M0 is the pole strength placed at that point, then formula will be magnetic force on pole strength placed at that point. So here, magnetic force as per Newton's law, as per Coulomb's law in magnetism, mu0 mu r divided by 4 pi, yes, M1 M2, means here M M0 upon r square. Now here, I think, yes, divided by M0 as it is, so this M0 M0 get cancelled, and hence formula for induction comes out, B is equal to mu0 mu r divided by 4 pi, yes, small m upon r square. This is due to monopole, means near to a single pole at a certain distance r, this is the induction. Like that, what will be formula for potential? Potential, we can write formula almost same, only difference is that mu0 mu r divided by 4 pi, yes, small m divided by r. So this is for potential, this is for induction. Induction is vector, potential is a scalar quantity. Now here, magnetic force between two pole strength, it is always given by Coulomb's law in magnetism. Same, Coulomb's law in electrostatics, constant was 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 k. You have to replace that constant by mu 0 mu r divided by 4 pi. Yes, and electric charges you have to replace by pole strengths m1, m2, are also called as magnetic charges, and square of distance between them, SI unit is Newton. So these are the analogies between electricity and magnetism, on the basis of which we can write these three equations. This is for force of attraction or repulsion between two pole strength. This is for induction, so basic mu0 mu r upon 4 pi small m upon r square. For M pole direction is outward, S pole it is inward. Magnetic potential as per basic formula 1 turn upon post then we can write mu 0 mu r upon 4 pi small m upon r. So these are very very important terms and formulae while solving numericals. Okay, thank you.